Okay, in this example, we're going to look at using arrays. It's a simple program that will input 10 numbers and then output those numbers in reverse order on the screen. So first things first, declaring the array, we declare number as an integer, and then in brackets we put the number 10, which means we're going to reserve 10 spaces, integer sized, in contiguous spaces in RAM. Okay. So we're going to have 10 different elements in our array, or 10 different placeholders. So we can store 10 different values in our number array. Okay. And how we refer to that later will be num, the index of, so nums of 0 would be the first element of the array, okay, or the value of that first element, all the way up to nums of 9 would be the last one. So declaring it 10 in size, the actual positions will be 0 through 9. Okay, so 10 different numbers. I is going to be our counter. This is a for loop, so we're going to, again, three steps. We're going to initialize it. So I is going to start at 0. Where do we stop? At 10. So our loop condition, I, as long as I is less than 10, will loop. And how do we get there? Instead of I equals I plus 1, we can shorten that in C++ by just saying I plus plus. This is the increment operator. In other words, add 1. Okay. So the for loop, if you read in the last chapter, is just a shortened version when you know the number of times you're going to go through the loop. Okay. So it makes it very efficient. All three questions are answered in one line. So within that loop, we just say enter a number. We're going to cn the number sub. Now remember, we're going from what? 0 to not through 9. So each time when we're typing it in, we're typing into a different position in the array. So num sub 0, num sub 1, the next time through the loop, num sub 2, all the way up to 9. So we're typing them in one order. And then we have another for loop here, and notice we're going to start at 9. Okay, we're going to stop at 0. Notice the greater than or equal to, so we are including 0. And then I minus minus for our counter is going to be decrement, okay, or decrease by 1. Okay, so we're basically just going backwards through the array to print it on the screen, and we'll just say cout num sub I, and I will go 9, 8, 7, 6, all the way down to 0. Okay, and so let's see how this works. We'll compile it and run it. And if we put in numbers, let's make it easy. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. It's just going to output them back on the screen in reverse order. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so you get the idea. But the great advantage in arrays is declaring one variable or one array as opposed to one variable. And getting numerous elements instead of having to declare 10 different variables to deal with those numbers. And it remembers all of them. Okay, you're storing them all so you can spit them back out on the screen, like in this case, in reverse order. Okay, so that was a simple example of how to use or declare and use arrays.